Today on Larry King Now, it's Jeff Garlin and Wendy McClendon Covey, two comedic forces aligned for the new comedy, The Goldbergs.
I never thought I'd be on a network show. It's just not, I'm not like a network kind of guy.
You're a cable guy.
Yes! Yeah. And then I get this script and I'm like, oh my God, this is great!
You're not Jewish.
I'm not Jewish. And yet I'm playing one on TV.
Yes, you are. Wow.
Look, overbearing mothers, they're universal.
Italian, right?
And I had one.
Plus, so you're everywhere.
I'm everywhere.
What was it like to work
with? I'm gonna haunt your dreams.
Anybody deserves major success.
Me.
You. All right, you
no have one to else, really, when you think about it. When you think about all of show business, who deserves major success?
Jeff
Me.
Garlin.
Anyone else? Nope.
That's all next on Larry King Now. Welcome to Larry King Now. I've looked forward to this because he's one of my favorite people. Jeff Garlin, the actor, comedian, writer, producer, director. He's everything. Best known for his role as Larry David's manager, Jeff Green, on HBO's hit series, Curb Your Enthusiasm, which should never go off the air. A show he also executive produced. Now Jeff has returned to TV as Murray Goldberg, the perpetually pantless patriarch in ABC's new hit comedy, The Goldbergs. Did you like this script right away?
Love it. Love it, love it, love it. I thought you were talking about what you just said.
tell me about Mr.
Well, actually, I would be shocked. I never thought I'd be on a network show. It's just not, I'm not like a network kind of guy. And then I get this script. As I was writing, all right, look, I'm always going to do Curb. I can still do Curb Your Enthusiasm. That was part of my deal with... Okay? So, but I always thought that was the kind of show I'd be on.
You're a cable guy.
Yes!
Yeah.
And then I get this script, and I'm like, oh, my God, this is great. I got to do this. So we worked it out, and every script, I get very excited.
Now, the concept is it's you, a wife, a kid.
Three kids, and my father-in-law. We're the Goldbergs, and we're in the 80s. It takes place in the 80s. But I'm more concerned with the stories and the characters being about something solid, something that's tangible, in terms of you can make it today and it would work. And the 80s happens to be the backdrop.
And the mother is a very Jewish mother, right?
Big boy, yeah. Well, I used to always say about, I never heard anyone use the joke until this show. I used to say, put S in front of mother, and that's my mother. You know, yeah. And that's what we do on this show. So she's quite the smother. Wendy McClendon Covey.
She's wonderful.
She's a big bowl of wonderful.
Oh, all my life, I never heard of the term the Jewish father.
Right.
It was always the Jewish mother.
Well, the Jewish father, when you really think about it, tries staying out of the way.
Mine does. When I was 9 and a half. So.
You were young.
Yeah.
My dad just let my mom, you know, whatever. Oh, it's all, as long as she doesn't bother him and they can watch a ball game, which is what I associated with this character.
Does he do that?
Yeah, like, yeah, go, it's good. He wants to be left alone. That's what I think most Jewish fathers want to be left alone, and you say yes to your wife. No matter what.
Are you having fun doing it? As it played out to the original script, to what it's become?
Oh, it's only gotten better, which is really exciting. And the work is a little bit hard for me because I have to learn lines.
Which you didn't have to do in
Curb. Never had to do on Curb.
They just gave you an outline, right?
Yeah, and stand up, I pretty much go up and start talking. I don't really have much prepared.
Were you in Second City?
I was in Second City also, so I'm an improviser. But with this, I work really hard. I have a dialogue coach. And she and I work very, very hard.
Do you like the character?
I love the character. And I like the character because I can associate with a lot of it. But, you know, he calls his kids morons and he's yelling all the time. That's not me. I'm very affectionate with my kids. My dad was affectionate.
You work with Stephen Colbert at Second City?
Yes, but as much as Stephen and Colbert and I worked together, and we were on stage together many times, but... We worked in the box office at Second City.
Selling tickets?
Selling tickets and taking reservations. Yes, that's where I did most of my work with Stephen Colbert in the box office.
You did funny things there, too?
I actually did do funny things. I remember if somebody was a jerk to me on the phone, because that's where it was on the phone. Okay, I would tell them that I'm putting them in the puppet section. It's the hardest section. There's puppets and marionettes. They go, what is this? I go, well, during the show, from the ceiling, marionettes drop up and drop down and puppets come out. So I would mark that, I would put P.S. next to their name. It was rarely on there, and they'd know puppet section. So I would show up on the puppet section night just to watch, and you'd have these people who were jerks, but the whole show they'd be looking up, and it was great. I loved doing that. Yeah.
How did you meet Larry David?
At a gentle lovemaking seminar. Just both of us trying to tone it down. We were comedians in New York. That's how I first met him.
He was a stand-up, Larry?
Larry's a great stand-up, yeah.
And then he came up with, how did he put you into this show? How did Curb Your Enthusiasm?
Curb Your, you know, I was writing a show in a suite of offices with a mutual friend of ours, Alan Zweibel, and he asked me to lunch one day, and Alan couldn't go, so just the two of us at lunch. And I had been on the road with Dennis Leary and Jon Stewart, helping them make their comedy specials. I was, you know, developing their specials with them. So we were talking about comedy, whatever, and he said, HBO's talking to me about doing something. I said, well, if you do, a great thing to do would be behind the scenes of a making of an HBO special. And I was going to direct it. I wasn't even going to be in it. Really? And that was his idea that I play his manager. Yeah, you know, it's a great thing when you bring an idea to a genius.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
I mean,
why does that show work? We went on vacation, took all the tapes, and just watched them.
Two reasons why. Obviously, it's funny. And two, it's irreverent. And when I say irreverent, not irreverent just for irreverence sake, but it's not remotely politically correct. It just does. It's an intelligent man operating from an id.
Right, but that's also, he's himself.
No.
No, Larry's a lot like that.
No.
No?
No. He'd hate me for saying this. He's a gentleman, and he's a great guy, and I don't know how much of a gentleman the character is. I think he's a good guy, the guy on the show, but Larry's a great guy. I mean, certainly it's like him because, you know, he's funny in the same way sometimes, but Larry is very thoughtful and considerate.
Now, your career is going to spiral now beyond cable.
Yes.
Be a hit in the
network. I'm going to be gigantic.
You're going to be enormous.
Enormous. It's going to be, it's actually already, it's almost impossible to stop me.
That's right.
You could actually have, your agenda today could be, I'm going to slow down the Jeff Garland train. You can't. It's left the station.
I'll tell you how I'm going to slow it down.
How's that?
We're going to talk baseball when we come back.
Oh.
I'll slow it down.
For most Americans, that does slow it down.
We're back with Jeff Garland. He stars in The Goldbergs, which has been contracted through the whole season.
Yes, contracted through the whole season, yeah. And hopefully many seasons to come, because I love it.
You deserve it.
Thank you.
If anybody deserves major success.
Me.
You. All right. You
no
have
one
to
else, really, when you think about it. When you think about all of show business, who deserves major success?
Jeff Garland.
Anyone else? Nope.
You grew up in Chicago.
You're a Cub fan.
Never seen a World Series victory.
69 was my first heartbreak.
That's right. They blew the pennant way ahead.
Yeah.
Well, I remember 45. I was 12 years old. They lost to the Tigers in 7 games.
Yes.
What is it like to be a Cub fan? What's it like?
It's there's two levels of being a Cub fan. There's the years where we're not bad. We're pretty good. And it's kind of fun. And then there's those hopeless years. At least now I have Theo Epstein in charge and I feel confident. But I have to say, there's been a number of years where the team is hopeless and you look at the front office and the ownership and you go, this is just all hopeless. And hopelessness is not enjoyable.
I was one of the bidders to be one of the owners of the Dodgers until someone went $2 billion. Would you like to own a piece of the Cubs?
I want to own the Cubs completely. I want to be the sole owner of the Cubs.
It's not going to sell.
Well, look, as successful as I'm going to be, I will own the Cubs someday.
That's right. Wait a minute. You're an empire.
I am.
You can buy him out.
I will. I'm not an empire yet, but I will be. Yeah. And I will buy everybody out.
You just wrote and directed your second film, Dealing with Idiots.
Yes.
I take this personally because it's about parents of Little League players.
Yes, it is.
I am one of those parents.
Yes.
But they're just out of Little League now.
Yes.
This is, I guess, putting them down.
Who?
The parents.
Yes.
Why do you do this? Were you a Little League parent?
Yes, I was. Well, you say Little League. By the way, in my movie, I couldn't say Little League because it's an organization.
Who was in it?
Ava Goda.
Oh, I love Ava.
No, I was kidding. He's not in it.
No.
I'm sorry. But Bob Odenkirk, J.B. Smoove, who plays Leon on Curb Your Enthusiasm, Jamie Gertz,
Why didn't
Gina
it
Gershon.
Work?
No, it worked. It just was a little indie movie, and, you know.
Gina Gershon's terrific.
She is terrific, yeah.
How's about your podcast? Why haven't I been interviewed yet on your podcast?
As they say in Sweden, I'd love to have you.
You got me.
All right.
When do you do it?
Like once a month, twice a month.
You interview people. Where do you do it?
I do it at Largo, which is a
restaurant,
a theater on La Cienega Boulevard. And I've had Michael Moore, Larry David.
I'd love to do it.
Yeah, oh, well,
do you enjoy interviewing people?
Yeah, I would have. By the way, I have great questions for you.
Like?
Talking about Lenny Bruce, talk about Miami.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Be right. Bagel
talk
back.
About delis. Talk about a good bagel. I know.
Brooklyn water bagel.
I know.
In there?
But I'm
there every day. Come on.
I'm not eating wheat right now.
Oh.
Yeah, it makes me too fat.
Oh, we have some questions for you. Twitter questions.
Okay, Twitter questions.
Claudia Cuellar. What was your inspiration?
Wait, wait. Claudia Cuellar? Mike Cuellar's daughter?
Could be.
I know. Go ahead.
Mike Cuellar was a great pitcher with the Orioles.
Yes.
What was your inspiration for I Want Someone to Eat Cheese With, one of my favorite movies?
My inspiration was a lot of hurt and unrequited love built up over time. One woman in particular, actually, who went on to be a big TV producer and director.
Really?
Yeah, it was mostly based on my heart. She was actually the original producer, which was ironic, but it sort of fell apart, but I still like her.
We got a little game called If You Only Knew. Ready?
It's a little game.
Little game, yeah.
Not a big game.
We don't have much time. First girl.
Why is that, Larry?
I don't know.
Wait, hold on. Why do we not have much time?
All right, I'll take more time.
Yeah. You know, Ted Koppel used to be able to do that. Ted Koppel used to be the one who turned to the camera and go, I want to inform the affiliates I'll be going 15 minutes over this evening.
I used to do that and with CNN sometimes.
Well, then you... And you can't do it on the internet? You can't just put your fist down and
say... The guy is right. Screw it.
Yeah, you're
okay.
Larry King.
First girl
inform
you...
Inform the affiliates on this camera.
First girl you ever kissed.
Linda Kleinstein behind my house in Morton Grove, Illinois.
How old were you?
Probably 6, 5.
Whatever happened to Linda Kleinstein?
I don't know. I wish good things for her.
Greatest stand-up act you've ever seen?
In person?
Yeah.
This is going to surprise people because my favorite all-time comedian is Richard Pryor, what have you. Alan King.
Oh, the best.
I saw him live, and I was blown away. I couldn't believe how great he was.
Alan King, he started opening for Judy Garland at the Palace.
Right.
He was a master. He was angry,
mm-hmm.
and he did great bits about airplanes and insurance.
I know.
And he socked it to you.
He socked it to you. Yeah. He was a man of the people. But I saw him in Chicago maybe 15 years ago or so, you know, so not early on.
He was fun.
It was amazing.
Did you ever bomb on stage?
Did I ever bomb on stage? I think a more appropriate question would be, how many times have you bombed on stage? And I would guess 1,000.
What happened? What's it like to bomb on stage?
There's two feelings, if you care or if you don't care. Meaning, I don't care. I'll bomb. I'll throw it to the wind when I go up there. I'm happy to bomb. I'm not happy to bomb, but I'm fine with it. If an audience chooses, now, there are nights where I'm not funny. That hurts. So if you ask me if I'm ever not funny, that kills. That's a deep pain after it's over. But there are nights where I am so funny and so on, and the audience just nothing.
Doesn't get it.
And I say it's their fault.
You are one of my favorite people, Jeff.
Thank you.
Congratulations on everything happening to you. I'm going to
Thank
do
you.
Your podcast,
yes.
Bring back Curb Your Enthusiasm,
yes.
and continue with great success on the Goldbergs.
And as they say in Sweden, Larry, enjoy your suspenders.
Next up, Jeff's on-screen wife, the lovely Wendy McClendon Covey. Stay with us. Welcome to Larry King Now. Our special guest is Wendy McClendon Covey. You know her from her shows like Reno 911 and Rules of Engagement. She's one of the breakout stars of the blockbuster hit Bridesmaids, in which she played the unabashed bridesmaid Rita. And now she stars as the overbearing family matriarch in ABC's new comedy, The Goldbergs, which hurts me personally because I had a Jewish mother. And she was wonderful. She forgave everything I ever did in my whole life. How'd you get this part? You're not Jewish.
I'm not Jewish. And yet I'm playing one on TV.
Yes, you are.
I am playing a Jewish mama. But, you know, look, overbearing mothers, they're universal.
Italian, right? Too.
And I had one.
You did.
So I have a lot of
But Covey is like a German-American kind of Protestant name.
Yes, yes.
But you had an overbearing mother.
I had an overbearing mother, right. And what happened was they came to me last pilot season or right before pilot season started, and they, you know, I'd been reading some scripts and nothing was really that great, but they showed me this one. I thought it was funny, but then they showed me the home movies of these people, and that's what sold it.
The real
home movies. I want to be one of these lunatics.
Of them?
Yes.
What's the concept of this? I know it's a hit already, right?
Yes, it is a hit already.
They just
gave us a full season, so that's great for a new show. But Adam Goldberg, the creator of the show, someone bought him a video camera when he was a kid, and he filmed everything that ever happened in that house. So he has stacks of videotapes that he's converting to DVDs, and he showed me some embarrassing moments. I don't know how his family feels about this, but we've seen them in their underwear and everything else. I said, this is so insane that if I don't do this, I will die unhappy. Okay? Please give me this part. And they did. So it worked out. I think it's working out. And
Are you having fun doing it?
I'm having a blast doing it.
You worked a lot impromptu stuff, right?
Yeah, I've done a lot of improv.
And this is scripted.
This is scripted. Yeah, and we have some of the best writers in comedy today. People from Everybody Loves Raymond, The Big C, King of Queens, a lot of funny writers, and so they let us improv sometimes, but it doesn't really need it. The material's there.
Is it a thin line between making fun of a Jewish family and making it fun, rather than fun of?
Yeah, we don't really play up on that. And again, the show is set in the 80s, and that's just a backdrop as well. We don't really focus on those two things. The family just happens to be named Goldberg.
Is there an ongoing conflict?
The mom is holding on so tight that she's actually pushing them away. So she loves her babies. She is the CEO of that house, but they want nothing to do with her.
And the husband is?
Jeff Garlin.
And he is? What is he like?
He is such a dream on set, okay? I love playing his pretend wife. He is very funny. He's pantsless most of the time in our episodes. It's just a pants-off party for
Jeff.
Does
the mother control him?
To a degree, but they always form a united front. Even if he contradicts her right in front of the kids, she'll turn on a dime and say, well, that's what I was trying to say. they're always a united front in front of the kids.
You have to play comedy seriously, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you can't play it for it's laughable. You're not playing it for laughs.
Exactly. You have to be deadly serious.
You have to be that woman.
Yes, you do.
Beverly, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Beverly.
And she is a holy terror.
A couple of things about Bridesmaids. How'd you get that role?
Kristen Wiig and Annie Mumolo, the two writers, they got me into audition, but the part was not necessarily mine. They wrote it with me in mind, but I had to go in and go through several auditions. And
when you read it, did you know how hysterical it would turn out?
I knew I thought it was funny, but I have a weird sense of humor. So you never know what anybody is going to respond to. And then we did a lot of improv on that.
Did you think it would be a hit?
I just thought, well, this is fun. I'm having fun with my friends. We're all getting paid. I hope. You know, it's out of our hands after a certain point. You know,
but all of you burst out of that into successful careers, right? What about women in comedy? When I was a kid, there was Joan Davis on the radio. Mm-hmm. You wouldn't probably even know her.
No.
And then a couple of comedians came along, but very few.
Yeah.
Is it wide open now?
It's pretty wide open, and the material is getting better. But my whole thing with women in comedy is you can't make something that's not funny, funny. Okay, and women are interesting creatures, but you would not know it according to the books that are selling.
It's a men's club.
It's Look, 50 Shades of Grey, in my opinion, was a terrible book, but everybody bought it, so now there's a movie being made. You can't do something with terrible material.
So, but it's unfair to say that women are not funny.
That's completely unfair.
But that was,
we all had role models growing up. I loved Gracie Allen.
Gracie Allen was a great light comedian.
Hilarious woman. Vivian Vance and Lucille Ball.
Tremendous.
Carol Burnett. We all had role models, and
before them, it was a closed field.
It was pretty closed, yeah. Especially in stand-up and things like that.
Wendy on her comedic roots, and we'll take your questions too right after this. She's one of the stars of The Goldbergs. She is the family matriarch. She is Wendy McClendon Covey. What inspired, were you a funny kid?
I was a funny kid, and I learned early on that if I did funny things, I could sort of jolly my parents out of punishing me.
Some people, funny people, don't do improv well.
Okay.
They can even be funny stand-ups, but improv, were you natural at that? Where they throw out a subject and you do it?
I was always pretty quick. And I studied people, and I still study people. So I pick up those things. I'm a great eavesdropper, too. That's one of my God-given talents.
You're at an airport, you listen to
it? I listen to everything, and I save it up for when I need it. And I think that helps with improv.
You do stand-up?
No, I've never done it. That terrifies me. The thought of doing it terrifies me.
Why?
I would just feel like the court jester.
That's the best of all comedy. You're on that stage alone.
I just feel, I can't free fall like that.
You like scenes.
I like scenes, yeah.
Like acting.
Yeah.
Okay, you got more films coming out. One with Adam Sandler, another with Tyler Perry. You're on a roll.
I'm on a roll, yeah. And I've got a Christmas film out right now it's a very tiny little Christmas movie, but it's got Taryn Manning from Orange is the New Black.
What's it called?
It's called All American Christmas Carol, and it's on iTunes and
comedy?
On demand. Yeah, it's a comedy.
So you're everywhere.
I'm everywhere.
What was it like to work with?
I'm gonna haunt your dreams, Larry.
What was it like to work with Adam?
Oh my gosh, it was so much fun.
He's a
it was
great
Adam
guy.
Sandler and Drew Barrymore in the hot Georgia heat in August. But it was so much fun. It was like being on vacation.
He's a great guy.
He's a great guy.
Tyler
He's
Perry?
One of the producers of our show.
Do you like working with Tyler?
I loved working with Tyler. He works very fast. He edits as he films, so.
Okay, we have some Twitter questions for you. Lisa Claire wants to know, what female comedians throughout history did you most admire, and did any influence your style?
Again, I've got to say Gracie Allen, because she played that ditz so perfectly and was just dry about it. She never did that wink-wink thing towards the audience. Her, Madeline Kahn.
Great.
Amazing.
Young Frankenstein.
Oh, gosh, I adore her.
Kiss the cheek. Remember that at the train station.
And Lily Tomlin. Love Lily.
The best. Adam Hutton on Twitter wants to know, does The Goldbergs make you nostalgic for your own Wonder Years?
It does make me nostalgic. I love reliving all those years I was a teenager then, so now reliving it as a parent, I sort of empathize with my...
How old are the kids?
Now, I am not a parent. I just want to say I have no kids, but as a parent on the show.
How old are the kids on The Goldbergs?
They're playing a junior in high school, a senior in high school, and a seventh grader.
You like working with kids?
I love them.
They're good,
these kids? Are amazing kids, and yeah, they're pros.
Okay, we play a little game called If You Only Knew. Just throw out the question. Remember the first boy you kissed?
Yes.
What was his name?
His name was Bubba.
Bubba.
And that's not a joke. That
was
his name.
Where in the South was this?
It was in Arizona. It was on vacation. It was just a peck on the lips, but that peck got me through the ninth grade, Larry.
Whatever
I was a late bloomer.
What happened to Bubba?
Oh, who knows? He's probably in jail.
Is there a celebrity you wanted to be growing up?
I wanted to be Donna Dixon.
Donna Dixon.
She was gorgeous. She was on Bosom Buddies. She had the gorgeous hair and gorgeous... I just adored her.
What keeps you up at night?
Worrying that someone that I love will die.
Yeah. I worry about that.
Oh, it
I don't want to ever bury a friend.
Yeah.
What's a hidden talent you have we don't know about?
I'm double jointed in my armpits. And I have managed to parlay this into absolutely nothing.
I don't want to see it.
No, you don't.
Okay. But there are moments where it could be interesting. Okay. Do you have a favorite moment in Bridesmaids? A scene.
A favorite scene would probably be the restaurant scene where we're all eating Argentine food and we get really sick. Because that was such, it took us 3 days to film it, and there was
imagine.
So much improv going on. We laughed so hard during that whole thing. It was
most embarrassing moment.
I'm not telling. It's too embarrassing.
What's a guilty pleasure you enjoy?
Online shopping, naps, and baths.
Online shopping. Well, when you get
shopping in the bathtub.
Is it a surprise when it comes?
Sometimes it is. Sometimes I forget.
And one thing, you're stranded on a desert island. What three things you want to have with you?
Sunscreen, a Swiss Army knife, and my husband.
Thank you, doll.
Thank you.
Thanks to my guest, Wendy McClendon Covey. Watch her along with Jeff Garlin in The Goldbergs. ABC Tuesday nights, 9 Eastern. You can find me on Twitter at King's Things. Yep. See you next time.